What's up, Northerners? What's up, Steeler fans? This is Chris with my after-game review from the Steelers beating the hell out of Tennessee Titans today. Loved a lot of things I saw on the field today. And rather than throw a bunch of stats at you after watching this one, I'd rather talk about the top five things or my favorite five things that I saw during this game. Before that, though, let me talk about one of my favorite Steeler experiences. I was in Pittsburgh at a game one time. Was in the parking lot just hanging out with friends, tailgating after another win, when we decided to walk back to the car past the players' lot. And the first person I saw when I walked down there was Dick LeBeau, who now coaches for the Tennessee Titans, which is why it's so relevant. And Dick LeBeau was nice enough to sign my game towel. I've got, I don't know, 10 towels. I've got one for everything, one for work, one for car, one for the games. I got one I keep only in the house. But this is my game towel. This is my Dick LeBeau signed game terrible towel. If you see me in Pittsburgh, I'll probably have this with me. Getting back to the game. First thing I saw that I liked was a play from the secondary today. Specifically, Cody Sensabaugh, even though he did get burned pretty bad on that opening play of the second half, he comes in for the injured Joe Hayden. He has a pick. Sean Davis has a pick. Hilton has a pick. Golden has a pick. They're just giving them out today like Oprah. Love what I saw from those guys. Second thing I saw, it's not going to show up on a stat sheet. It's probably not going to show up in your highlight reel either. But the sacrifice I saw from Bell today, we already know what kind of workhorse he is. He's going to catch the ball. He's going to run the ball. He's going to do what he needs to do. But the blocking I saw today, specifically one play where he totally sacrificed his body for Ben, for the good of the team, couldn't ask him for any more. I think I heard Chris Collinsworth say the scouting report is his strength is he has no weaknesses. So deal with that. TJ Watt, the third thing, he is the real deal. You know, it would have been so easy for him to have such a fantastic debut and then just kind of lay in the weeds after that, but he really hasn't. He has not taken his foot off the gas one bit this season, whether it's on special teams, whether it's on defense. Everything he's doing, I absolutely love it. He's going to be good for years to come for us. The D-line played a hell of a game today. Marcus Mariota, I mean, these guys were in his face all day, every day. And everyone from the D-line came home with a sack today. The last thing I liked that I saw is just the type of leaders and the type of human beings that we have on Steelers offense. For them to not give up on Martavis Bryant, to almost force him to be the person he needs to be on and off the field, I love that. Having Ben, you know, not give up on throwing him the ball, not worrying about what's happening off the field, and the team, the coaching staff, taking him back, taking him in, saying, hey, you know, go this way, and then for Martavis Bryant to respond and make the changes he needs to make to get back on the field, to get back where he was last year, because I haven't seen any somersault catches yet, and I'm waiting for that to happen. So keep at it, Bryant. I mean, for you to take a season off and come back out there like you have, that's amazing. Very few men can do that. Very, very few men can do that. I mean, Adrian Peterson is like one of the few people I know that can take that kind of time off, come back on the field, and be just as good as he was. So with that, I will sign off, as we always do, with fuck the Patriots, love the Steelers, love Jack Lambert's balls, pause, and miss the guys from the show, man. I mean, hey, I love the work that Gabe's doing, but miss all three, four of you guys. Later.